Hello, everyone. I know we're excited about the new iPads that we have, and we're excited to get them in the classroom. But at the same time, we might be a little anxious about using iPads in the classroom since this is kind of new for us. Just like everything else in your classroom, you need to have rituals and routines for the iPads too. You want to create some type of system for them to pick them up off the cart. The iPads are numbered. You can assign an iPad to a student, which I would suggest doing anyway. When the students get the iPads, they're going to be mega excited about them and want to get their hands on them and turn them on right away. But a good technique to use is to have them turn the iPads over face down on their desk carefully until you have given directions. That way you ensure that the students are actually listening to you and not fumbling around on the iPad, which is what they want to do. Now, when you choose to use the iPads, you need to make sure that you have a purpose for that session with the iPads. You know, you may want to use two or three specific apps and tell the students that those two or three apps are the only apps that should be open. Now, in our training, we talked about how to tell which apps are open. And if you look on the bottom, you double-click on the home button. It shows you the apps that are open, okay? Ooh, somebody's been playing Candy Crush, okay? You can easily check students, walk around and monitor, which is also a very important part of using technology in the classroom, is to constantly monitor the students. You can do an app check. You can walk around. You can walk by and double click on the iPad. It will quickly show the apps that are currently open on the iPad. Now, if there are too many apps open because other students have used the iPad prior to your class, you can press and hold, and you see they start shaking, and there's a little delete button. You just touch the delete button. It's hard to do this backwards, okay? And the apps that you don't need open at the time will close, and then just to make them quit, to stop shaking, just press the home button again. That way, if they're working with Prezi and Safari and Notepad, those should be the only three apps open. And you can easily monitor that using the app check by double-clicking the home button. Okay? Well, good luck getting started with the iPads in the classroom. And I'll see you in the next training.